Hello and welcome to my channel English Literature Made Easy with Saswati. In this video I will talk about the novel Mrs. Dalloway, which is one of the most important modernist novels written by Virginia Woolf in the year 1925. So do stay tuned and watch the video till the end, and if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel then do subscribe to it and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you receive all the updates regarding my upcoming videos. So Virginia Woolf's novel Mrs. Dalloway is created from two short stories. They are Mrs. Dalloway in Bond Street and The Unfinished The Prime Minister. Like James Joyce's Ulysses, Mrs. Dalloway is set on a single day. So now let's look at some of the characters in the novel. The first character is the title character of the novel, Mrs. Dalloway, or Clarissa Dalloway as she is called. The 51-year-old protagonist of the novel is named Clarissa Dalloway. She is the wife of Richard Dalloway and mother of a 17-year-old teenage girl, Elizabeth Dalloway. She is a member of the upper class society of London and she is great at hosting parties. The second character is Richard Dalloway. Richard Dalloway is Clarissa Dalloway's husband. He is a member of parliament. He is described as practical and reliable by Clarissa Dalloway. He is most of the time immersed in his work as a parliamentarian, and because of that he has been detached from his wife. The third character is Elizabeth Dalloway. Elizabeth Dalloway is Clarissa and Richard Dalloway's 17-year-old daughter. She is not fond of attending her mother's party. Rather, she is interested in politics and modern history. And in the future, she wants to be a doctor or a farmer. And she wants to spend time with her father in the countryside. The fourth character is Septimus Warren Smith. Septimus is a World War I veteran who is suffering from shell shock and hallucinations of his friend Evans, who has died in the war. Shell shock is a kind of post-traumatic stress disorder with which many soldiers were afflicted during the war. The intensity of bombardment and horror around them had caused an acute sense of fear, panic, sleeplessness, and an inability to talk, walk, or reason. Because of that, a person suffering from shell shock becomes detached from the society and he has a dazed and a steady expression, which is like a blank expression, as you can see in this picture. The fifth character is Lucrezia Warren Smith. She is Septimus's wife. She is concerned yet disturbed or troubled by her husband's mental illness, and she thinks that people judge her because of her husband's mental illness. The sixth character is Dr. Holmes. Dr. Holmes is Septimus's unsympathetic general practitioner who believes that there is nothing whatever the matter with Septimus. The seventh character is Sir William Bradshaw. Sir William Bradshaw is a famous psychiatrist to whom Septimus's physician Dr. Holmes refers Septimus. More than a caretaker, he is an oppressor and makes sure that Septimus has a complete mental breakdown. Then he prescribes that Septimus be detained in a psychiatric hospital away from his wife and sole companion Lucrezia. The eighth character is Peter Walsh. He is an old friend of Clarissa Dalloway. Years ago, Clarissa had rejected his marriage proposal as she thought him to be rather unpredictable and married the reliable Richard Dalloway. He has shortly returned from India and he is one of the guests at Clarissa's party that evening. The ninth character is Sally Seton. Sally Seton is a female friend of Clarissa's from her days in Burton in England. Clarissa is strongly attracted to Sally, and even after 34 years, she considers the kiss that they shared to be one of the happiest moments in her life. Now Sally is married to Lord Rosader and she has 5 boys. She is also a guest at Clarissa's party that evening. The two women have not met each other for years, but Sally still puts Clarissa first when she counts her blessings. The tenth character is Miss Stillman, or Doris Stillman. She is Elizabeth Dalloway's history teacher. She is fired from her teaching job during the war because of her German ancestry and the society's anti-German prejudice during that time. She is over 40 and she wears an unattractive coat because she does not believe in dressing to please others. She does not like Clarissa, but she enjoys the company of Elizabeth. Apart from these, there are some other characters but those characters are mentioned just in passing in the novel, because the bulk of the novel concerns the characters Clarissa Dalloway and Septima Smith. Now let's look at the plot and narrative style of the novel Mrs. Dalloway. The novel Mrs. Dalloway is a plotless novel. If you have watched my earlier video on modernism and modernist literature or literary modernism, then you have definitely understood what I want to say. Those of you who haven't yet watched my earlier video, I'll put the link of the same in the description below, so you can check it from there. Now please understand that Mrs. Dalloway is a plotless novel because it is not written in the traditional linear plot and narrative style like the novels of the Victorian and the Edwardian era. It is a seminal modernist novel that breaks away from the linear plot or narrative style of the novels of earlier time. Unlike traditional plot-driven novels of the Victorian and Edwardian era, much of the action in Mrs. Dalloway takes place in the characters' minds, and Woolf needed a style that could depict the disjointed mess that life had become post-World War I. So like other modernist writers such as James Joyce and Marcel Proust, who were writing after the First World War, Virginia Woolf also used the narrative technique of stream of consciousness that could convey this post-war fragmented human consciousness. Now let's look at the plot, if it can be called a plot at all, of the novel Mrs. Dalloway. The novel details a day in Clarissa Dalloway's life in June 1923. So the narrative begins and ends with Clarissa. As the novel opens, Clarissa Dalloway, or Mrs. Dalloway as she is called in the novel, gets ready to host a party at her house in London in the evening. And in the morning, she steps out of her house to buy flowers for her party. Her mood is in continuous flux. At some moments, she goes into a flashback and recalls her youthful days in Burton in London, and she is delighted. At others, she is depressed and she thinks about death, which is quite natural in that post-war time of horror and destruction. So Clarissa reads the words from a funeral song from Shakespeare's play Timberline in a bookshop window as she steps out to buy flowers for her party. Fear no more the heat of the sun, nor the furious winter's rages. It means that death should be embraced as a means of release from the burden of endurance. Please note that these words are repeated by the war veteran Septimus before committing suicide towards the end of the novel. Clarissa returns home and meets her former lover, Peter. As the two meet, after so many years, Clarissa is flooded with memories of a time long gone by. Peter also makes her wonder about her past decisions and her choice of husband. Clarissa married the reliable Richard Dalloway in spite of repeated efforts and proposals made by the enigmatic Peter Walsh. Here, Clarissa also remembers that she didn't have the option to be with her close female friend Sally Seton. Peter Walsh leaves and goes to Rosen's Park, where he observes a First World War veteran, Septimus Warren Smith. Now, the narrative perspective shifts to Septimus, who is suffering from shell shock, which is identified as post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD in short. Septimus was a budding young poet and loved reading Shakespeare, but now he is waiting in the park with his wife Lucrezia to see a psychiatrist named Sir William Renshaw. Septimus has frequent hallucinations of his dear friend Evans, who died in the war. However, the other characters are unable to understand Septimus and what he is going through. With Septimus, Woolf is showing how the remnants of the war was still there in London in 1923. The novel's perspective then shifts to Richard Dalloway, Clarissa's husband. He wants to run home and tell Clarissa that he loves her, but he is unable to do so, and he gives her flowers instead. Clarissa values this gulf that exists between people, even her and her husband, as it gives both of them freedom and independence. Meanwhile, Septimus is told that he is to be taken to a psychiatric hospital. Septimus is traumatized at the thought of confinement away from his sole companion, Lucrezia. He cannot fathom to see himself inside a closed place, a confined place. So to avoid his fate, he commits suicide by jumping out of a window. The narration again shifts back to Clarissa. It is already evening and she is busy entertaining her guests in the party, who are all upper class Londoners. She hears about Septimus's suicide from the psychiatrist, Sir William Bradshaw's wife, at the party. At first, Clarissa is annoyed with the news, as it might diminish everyone's spirits. She tries to ignore the uncomfortable realities of her surroundings and wishes to live in her own bubble with all its supposed disillusionment of freedom. But once she is in her room, all by herself, she identifies with Septimus. Though Septimus is a stranger to her, as she has never met him, yet Clarissa respects the stranger's act, which she considers to be an effort to preserve the integrity of his soul rather than allowing it to be confined. As against this effort to preserve his soul, Clarissa feels ashamed of herself and her ways of compromising her own soul at the cost of a life that is highly pretentious. So this is all about the plot of the novel. Now let's look at some of the themes of the novel. So the first theme is mental illness. Please understand that people were least aware about mental illness during the 1920s. Even supposed caregivers like Dr. Holmes and Sir William Bradshaw were traumatizing the one who needed help. Wolf herself was suffering from several mental breakdowns and she had been to institutions. Through Septimus, Wolf offers a criticism of the treatment of mental illness and depression that was there in London in the 1920s. Rather than understanding Septimus and his mental trauma, Dr. Holmes suggests Septimus to take bromides, which was, however, used to treat epilepsy, play golf, and go to the music hall. On the other hand, the renowned psychiatrist Sir William Bradshaw prescribed him to be institutionalized in a psychiatric hospital away from his wife and sole companion Lucrezia. Instead of offering love and compassion, they make his life intolerable by forcing him to give up his freedom, his soul, to their restrictive confinement. Ultimately, Septimus is forced to give up his life because he is not ready to give up his soul. The second theme is the theme of time. Time plays an integral role in the novel. Like Joyce's Ulysses, the time frame of the novel, Mrs. Dalloway, covers the course of a single day. The ringing of the Big Ben at regular intervals reminds the reader of the passing of time and the impending threat of death. As against this idea of the passage of time, there are characters like Septimus, for whom time has been frozen, time has stopped. A war veteran who has seen the horror of war and devastating time, Septimus cannot demarcate between past or present, life or death. And he is constantly haunted by thoughts and images of his dead friend, Evans. Then there is Virginia Opsis' narrative style that highlights her idea of time as a fragmented yet a constant flow without the demarcation of the past, present and future. The stream of consciousness narrative style captures this idea of the fluidity of time. Please remember how Clarissa Dalloway is constantly revisited by thoughts of her past life in Burton, her present upper class life as the wife of a parliamentarian, along with its privileges and pretensions, as well as the reality of death conveyed by Septimus's death. Everything is conveyed in the course of a single day. The third theme is class distinction in society. It was the 1920s and British society was still very conservative and hierarchical, as seen in the novel Mrs. Dalloway. Clarissa Dalloway is an upper class woman, being the wife of a parliamentarian. She loves throwing parties and all her guests are from the higher social class. Even the Prime Minister comes to her party as a guest. And please note that people like Miss Kilman or Doris Kilman, Elizabeth's history teacher, do not like Clarissa, partly because they are beneath Clarissa in class, in social class. So these are some of the themes that can be found in the novel Mrs. Dalloway. I'm sure there will be some more themes as you read the text in detail. So please let me know about your doubts if you have in the comment section below, and if you also want me to make videos on some particular topics, you can write to me in the comment section as well. So I'll see you soon in another video. Till then, take care of yourselves.